Hi guys, this is Katie Bunschoten, the president and founder of Certum Solutions. And this week we are meeting with our very talented project services director, Mr. Sam Johnson. And he is going to give us an overview of advanced reporting in QuickBooks and also talk about a third party option that you may not know about and kind of what you would think about, you know, would you go to advanced reporting? Would you use standard reporting or would you go to one of these third parties? One of the great things about QuickBooks Enterprise is that there are 100 ways to do things and reporting is no different. So with that being said, I would love to turn the reins over to Mr. Johnson. Sam, if you wouldn't mind, how do we access advanced reporting?
Yeah, so advanced reporting, it's accessed very simply from the reports menu. If you look at the top here, you'll see an option for advanced reporting. We just simply click that and then it's going to open up this nice big window here. And then we are going to update we're going to have it update for us. This usually takes a couple minutes or so, just depending on the first time will take a lot longer, obviously. And then if you do this frequently, same thing with everything else in QuickBooks, the more frequent you access this area, the more frequent the updates will be.
That's a great call out because I was actually about to say that. that's fantastic call out. So we'll just wait for those steps to take place. So Sam, while we're waiting for that to happen, what is QCube?
Yeah, so QCube is on the basis of it, QCube is an ODBC connection that takes and really enhances the advanced reporting module that QuickBooks has. It allows you to be able to access all the dimensions and fields of QuickBooks in Excel, in Crystal Reports, in Power BI, and in Microsoft Access. As someone who has a bias for Excel and really likes the software, I really like QCube because it allows me to take data from Excel, from QuickBooks, put it into Excel and use pivot tables.
I love pivot tables. So that's awesome. That's great information. Thank you. And then like with advanced reporting, what do you think it adds to the standard reports that are in QuickBooks Enterprise? I believe in there are like over 150 standard reports at this point.
Yeah. So what it adds is it adds a way for you to combine different reports together. It allows you to take fields from other reports, kind of the same backend fields that we are talking about. QuickBooks runs on database tables. So it allows you to take those database tables and take components of it and combine them in different reports to get a report that gives you more information or more specialized information to show exactly what you're looking for.
That's fantastic. And with that being said, it looks like we're just about done with the sync. Yeah. Look at that. So we timed that perfectly. So we'll just let that bad boy get moving. And then, so my understanding with advanced reporting is that you have, with advanced reporting, you have like a series of tables and you have a bunch of different objects that you can add. Would you mind showing us some of those and maybe some of your thoughts on, you know, some best practices when someone is using an advanced reporting report?
Yeah. So whenever you open up advanced reporting, you're going to come to a nice little home screen. It's going to pull up last reports that you've looked, kind of a little last table that you've looked at, and go from there. What I usually like to do with advanced reporting and with Cube is to open up their standard reports list because they've already done a lot of the work for you. They've already started these reports here, and then you can go from there and start adding in additional information that you need. And start getting and start really customizing it for your needs.
That's awesome.
We can pick here, and we'll pick this profit and loss by job report. Pretty standard report that everybody wants to see. We're going to open that up, and then it's going to give us a nice breakdown of all of our jobs here. Like, you know, standard profit and loss by job report. I can already access this in QuickBooks. Why do I need advanced reporting? What QuickBooks allows you to do is you can actually take and if you right click, you can go into properties and then you go into dimensions. And all of these fields here, there's 1,000 something of them. I do not know the exact number.
Yeah.
They all become open for you to add into your report. Now, you have to think of this kind of in a in a logical sort of way. Whereas if you're adding a dimension and it's not related to something that's already in there, then it's not going to really show up correctly. So if you're trying to add add a job, you know, a job balance, project balance, and there's nothing in there that identifies what the jobs are, the dimensions aren't going to work together. So you do have to add them in a certain order to get them to work.
That makes perfect sense. Now, I also know that a lot of executives like visual dashboards. Can advanced reporting be used by someone who's trying to create a visual dashboard?
Yeah, it can. You can do charts.
That's awesome. Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So we'll go in and add a simple little address field here. So what this will do is it's going to add it to the bottom. If we want to bring that up farther, we can just hit promote, and it will basically move it up and down the list. And then we also have expressions that we can do. So these are going to be like your calculated fields. So you can add in extra calculated fields here. Right now we just have a standard amount. If we want to add in another function or expression here, we could add that in as well.
And I think that's another great thing about advanced reporting is because most of the QuickBooks standard reports don't do calculated fields, right?
Correct. Okay.
So then this would be an awesome example where if somebody is in need of a calculated field and they're able to do those scripts or find somebody that works in BI reporting that can do those scripts, then they can, you know, create those calculated fields to their heart's content. Would that be accurate?
Correct. Yeah. As you can see awesome. Too, it's not just simple. It's not just simple addition, subtraction, for function expressions. You do have to actually put in a little bit of coding expressions in there by this kind of like your sample right there.
That's awesome.
So we're gonna apply that, and inside of the this properties menu, you have other options for layouts, visual cues, presentation style, really just to make the report what you want. A lot more of those formatting options that you have versus using standard reporting.
That's awesome. Cool. So there are sample reports, there's calculated fields. Usually how long would you say it would take if somebody's trying to create, say, a custom report with some calculated fields, how much time should they put aside to work on that?
So to set up the initial report, depending on how well you know just reporting tables in general, this is like most reporting programs where if you understand one, you can kind of translate the concepts to another. It probably could take, a couple hours or so to set up your first report, especially going from scratch. You do have the option to also in here to start from scratch.
Oh, wow. That's very cool.
If you don't want to go from your pre-built template, you can simply start from scratch. And it's going to just load up a blank report.
Blank here. Slate, so to speak.
Huh? Blank slate, yeah. So then you have your list boxes here. So the side over here is going to be your objects for a report. So if we wanted to bring in income accounts, it's going to show up right here. We can stretch it and bring that information in and then go to our properties for each box. We can also add in, something for inventory items. Same concept as before though, where you have to think of it in a logical order where if, A plus B equals C, you have to put A first, then B to get to C.
That makes perfect sense. And I know that if somebody is new to advanced reporting, as Sam mentioned, there are, if you're familiar with a lot of reporting applications, moving to advanced reporting shouldn't be too difficult. But if you are looking for training or you're starting this from the beginning, there is a training library or training lab on the QuickBooks website that can help with some of that for our enterprise users. That's awesome.
There's very useful videos. Additional videos up into it directly that go over the advanced reporting in a lot greater detail than this.
That's awesome.
If those don't help you, we are happy to help as well.
That's awesome. And that is definitely a big call out. So if you do need help with advanced reporting, you want some training, or you just need someone to build a custom report, please make sure to reach out to us at Certum Solutions. We're going to take care of you. And then if you like this video, this particular type of video, and you want to see more about advanced reporting, make sure you like the video at the bottom. If you like this kind of content and you want to see more from Certum Solutions, make sure to subscribe to our channel. I can never remember which direction it's in. And with that being said, Sam, what about Q-Cube? Would you mind showing us a little bit of what Q-Cube looks like? And we already talked about what you like better about Q-Cube versus advanced reporting, or why somebody may go to one versus the other, but it'd be cool to see a visual of kind of what Q-Cube looks like.
We can definitely pull up Q-Cube. One thing I want to do before we pull up Q-Cube, you do have to do a quick little setup inside of your QuickBooks file to actually be able to do Q-Cube. To access it.
And is it Cube or is it Q-Cube?
It is Cube. It is Cube.
Oh, okay, cool. I've always called it Q-Cube, that's good to know.
So to access it, what you'll need to do is you'll need to go into your file and utilities, and then in Enterprise, you'll need to be in multi-user to access it. To set up and link it, first time you have to be logged in as admin and multi-user, and you're going to want to set up a custom reporting user. So you hit custom reporting and then hit manage ODBC users, and then you're going to set up your user here. You're going to want to give it all the permissions that it gives you. Just really go from there. Simple as setting up a user in QuickBooks. If you've done that before, this is going to be a lot of the part.
Awesome. Well, if we could just get a quick view. I know we're actually coming up on time, so we're coming up on 30. But if we can get a quick, so this is Q-Cube, this is the interface.
This is the interface for Cube. And since it does go through Excel, we'll pull up a quick quick job cost detail report here. What this is going to do is going to open it up in Excel for us. And once it opens, it's going to open up Excel, and it actually runs a database link through Excel. So it's going to ask you, very first pop up, it's going to ask you to refresh everything. You'll see, yes, and what's nice about you is once you've made the report and has that connection established, you can just open up your Excel report, and it's going to actually update the information for you. So you can make it where you have that connection there, and once it's done, you aren't having to reestablish it every time.
Awesome. I didn't mean to interrupt, but it said on the other tab that you can use this for AIA billing too, which is huge for our construction clients.
Yes, you can use it for AIA billing.
Okay.
Inside of Cube, you see it works just like a pivot table. You have all your options over here. You can actually go in, and they do have this attachment here. So you'll hit this Cube button. It'll install into your Excel. You hit Select Assistant, and it opens up all of these values here, and we just have one expanded for job cost values. We have all these other options up here, so there's a plethora of options, almost more than advanced reporting. Like I said, if you understand reporting and understand and can figure out and understand the names of how everything works, it's pretty easy to get and work with it.
That's awesome. Well, thank you, Sam, for running us through this. Before we conclude, are there any other call outs that you think we need to know?
Not at this time. I will say for both of them, definitely it's a trial by error. There's a lot of stuff that you have to do to get it to work. There is endless possibilities between both of these reporting softwares. And once you get everything worked out, you're going to open up a whole new world on the insights of your business.
That's awesome. Definitely. Any insights are it's great because, you know, data is everything. And when we have this data, being able to use it in impactful ways is so important. So,
yes.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Sam, for your time. And then thank you, everybody, for our viewers. We are so excited. We are going to make sure that we have Sam on here pretty often because he is just a wealth of information. If you have any questions about this video, any comments, please make sure to leave them below or shoot us an email over at contact@certumsolutions.com. And we will also drop some other contact information and additional resources in the description of this video. Thank you again. And I hope everyone has a fantastic day. Bye.
Thank you.